Hi students, let us continue our topic, types of reports now. So types of report, progress reports. So progress reports, these reports gives information regarding the progress made on particular project or an assignment over a period of time. So here progress report means, for example, we have given an assignment to you in a lockdown. So in the period of lockdown, from 10th to 25th 25th April, you have to write an assignment in 3 units of 4 subjects. So you have to submit at 25th April. So in meanwhile, I have called you many times, what is the progress of your assignment? So what is the status of your assignment? I asked you. So many of you tell me, madam, 3 units are completed from English subject, from chemistry subject. Madam, 2 units are completed from so and so subject. So you have told me about your completion. So this is about progress reports. So progress reports means, these reports gives information regarding the progress made on particular project or an assignment over a period of time. Okay, next, justification reports. Here justification reports means these reports that justify specific recommendations or proposals. So this justifies specific recommendations and proposals. For example, see here, tedious reports. These reports consist of various defaults or errors identified by the income tax department. So at the end of financial year, so business people submit their tedious report to the income tax department. So by the income tax department, some errors are fined by income tax department. So then they will send these errors, these documents back to that person. So they will rectify these finding errors, and they will correct these errors, and they'll send these statements, corrected statements, to that income tax department again. So this is about justify specific recommendations and proposals. So for example, TDS reports. Next, compliance report. Compliance report, it refers to the reports created by companies in order to comply to rules, standards, laws and regulations set by regulatory bodies and government agencies. So compliance refers means the reports created by the company in order to comply to rules of that company and standards. What is the standards of that company, and what are the laws and regulations set by the regulatory bodies and the government agencies. So this is nothing but rules and regulations of that company, and what are the standards of that company and regulations set by the regulatory bodies and government agencies. So next, annual report. Annual report is a comprehensive report on an organization's activities throughout the year. So for example, take our college. So in the year, academic year starts 2021. So it has conducted orientation program and orientation program and freshers party and Independence Day, Teachers Day, so and so. So programs it has conducted, and Technotsav and cultural meet, etc. It has conducted by our college. So at the end of annual day, the principal will read out what is the annual report of this college. So what is the annual report? So the organization's activities come. So the report on a organization's activities throughout the year, conducted throughout the year. This is about annual report. Next, feasibility reports. So a feasibility report is a document that assess the potential solutions to the business problems or opportunities. So feasibility reports means that document assess potential solutions. So potential solutions to the business problems. In and determining which these are viable or further analysis. It also states a need or proposal, idea or recommendations, a course of action based on that. So for example, cost benefit of investing in new IT system for a particular organization, feasibility of using alternative fuels. For example, so this feasibility reports, it gives some, it assesses the potential solutions to that business problems or opportunities, and it determines of their viable further analysis. So it also states a need or proposed idea to recommend a course of action based on that. Next, business plans. So this is very important. So business plans, business plan is a proposal to start a new business or a venture. So business plan is a proposal start a new business or a venture. It would be talk about, it includes about investments. What is the investment to start a new business, and what are the methods they have to use for the production, and the, what is the market value. So the market in which the product will be sold, what is the market value of that production. Then findings, what are the findings, the what are the returns they will expect. So they will write in the business plans. So it is a formal written document containing business goals, the method on how these goals can be attained, on the time frame within which these goals need to be achieved. So in the business report, they have to write, they will write their investments, what are the methods of production, and what is the market value for the what market value to, will be sold to that product, and what are the findings, and what are the returns they will expect from that product. So, and also it is a formal written document containing business goals, the methods on how these goals can be achieved. So what are the what are their goals, and how can they achieve these goals. So this is about business plans. Next, book reports. So this is very important, book reports. A book report is a formal essay discussing the contents of a book. So a report is a formal essay discussing the contents of a book. It summarizes the important aspects of a book, such as the title, author, plot and characters, while showing that the reader understand what he or she has read. So about the book report, it contains about it summarizes the important aspect of a book, such as title, those are title, who is the author, what is the plot, and what are the characters involving in that. So it, these shows, this book report shows the what a reader he or she has read. It is not a book review which requires the writer to give personal opinion about the book. So the book reports, it is not a book review a writer to give personal opinion about the book. For example, we should take Merchant of Venice, a book, Merchant of Venice. The report would includes book's title. So about that Merchant of Venice, that includes first book's title. What is the title, Merchant of Venice? Who is the author? Who is the author of this Merchant of Venice? Shakespeare. So next, brief description of that plot. So what is the theme, what is the summary, what is the gist, what is the plot. So who are the characters in that book? So what are the characters involved in that book? What is the theme of that play? So this is about book reports. So these are including in the book report. What are the those included in that book report? Book's title, author, and plot, and characters of that play, and theme of the play. Next, so language is using for report writing. So there is a language is using for a report writing. So what is the language we have to use while writing a report? So it should be, the language should be simple and concise style is using in writing report. Simple language we have to use, and concise style of language we have to use, and focusing on facts. So no need to write extra information, just you have to focus on facts and avoid emotive language. So no need to write a very emotive languages and attractive language, no need, just facts you have to write. You have to focus on facts. Next, our writing must be crisp. Do not frame sentences with multiple clauses. Do not frame your sentences with multiple clauses. Multiple clauses means if clause. So do not write complex sentences. So just you have to write simple sentences. Everyone should be understand. Next, it should be write informal document. Just formal document. Avoid using contract forms of verbs. So don't use contract forms of verbs. Use correct spellings, grammar and punctuations. So while writing report, so you have to use correct spellings and grammar and punctuation. Grammar nothing but to use proper sentences. Next, write abbreviations or acronyms completely. Don't write US, you just write United States. So you have to write abbreviations and acronyms completely. Next, avoid using pronoun I. So don't use I, me, these type of pronouns. As a report, it should be objective in tone. So it should be objective in tone and passive voice. Use active voice wherever possible. So wherever possible, you have to use active voice. Report should be a judicious mix of sentences in active and passive voice. So you have to use active and passive voice wherever it requires. So this is about report writing. So by students, this is about report writing. So in the next session, we are going to learn new, I am coming with a new topic. Thank you.